Welcome to Lab 360 for all the latest news from the world of astronomy. We're nearing the day when we will finally be able to send people back to the moon, for the first time since 1972. Ever since this program was announced in 2019, people all over the world haven't been able to hold their excitement. The Artemis 1 lunar mission, which was previously known as Exploration Mission 1, will be NASA's first major step towards bringing astronauts back to the moon's surface. It will be the first test flight of NASA's new Space Launch System, Mega Rocket, and the Orion crew capsule. The uncrewed flight of the Space Launch System rocket and the Orion spacecraft will be critical in getting the two technologies ready for human flights to the moon later this decade. The systems will work together to provide not just valuable human testing, but also to transport humanoid and robotic passengers for science and PR objectives. On the 2nd of April, lightning struck the launch pad of NASA's massive Artemis 1 moon rocket several times. But the rocket was unharmed while technicians completed a vital test. Four lightning strikes struck the area around the launch pad, where NASA's first Space Launch System Mega Rocket was undergoing a three-day wet dress rehearsal for its Artemis 1 mission. Three towers and a catenary wire structure protected the rocket from lightning strikes, by diverting hits to the ground and away from the booster rocket. The first three strikes were very passive, but the fourth one was one of the strongest ever seen. The enhanced protection kept the rocket safe. The upgraded lightning protection system provided better shielding from these strikes and ensured that the rocket didn't come under any harm. On the 3rd of April, 2022, NASA was conducting the wet dress rehearsal procedure, when complications arose that led to the process being stopped. Due to a loss of ability to pressurize the mobile launcher, the team opted to cancel tanking activities for the wet dress rehearsal. The fans are required to maintain positive pressure in the mobile launcher's enclosed compartments and to keep dangerous gases out. Without this capability, technicians will be unable to properly load propellants into the rocket's core stage, and interim cryogenic propulsion stage. Artemis 1 is the SLS's first uncrewed launch, with the rocket and Orion spacecraft being tested in space to determine if they work as intended, as well as transporting the names of people all over the world into orbit. Artemis 2 will send humans into space for the farthest voyage ever from Earth, reaching beyond the moon over a 10-day mission if everything goes according to plan. After that, Artemis 3 will return four humans to the moon's surface. The original date of 2024 has been moved back to 2025, due to the pandemic. The goal of this week-long mission is to return back moon samples that will reveal more about the satellites and Earth's history. We cannot wait. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below, and don't forget to Lab 360 for all the latest news from the world of astronomy.
The very first nation to reach the surface of the moon was the Soviet Union. A man-made spacecraft known as the Luna 2 arrived at the surface of the moon in 1959. Fast forward a decade later, and the first manned mission landed on the moon on the 20th of July, 1969. It was a historic day for mankind, or as rightly put by Neil Armstrong, it was one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. The last manned mission to the moon was Apollo 17, taking place between 7 and 19 December 1972. It was a 12-day mission and broke many records, such as the longest spacewalk, the longest lunar landing, and the largest lunar samples brought back to Earth. After that, there has been no manned mission to the moon, and with technology at its peak today, it was only a matter of time before we sent humans to the moon again. Enter Artemis 1. NASA has finally made the announcement that we've all been waiting for. The Artemis 1 is going to be an uncrewed test flight for NASA's Artemis program. This mega rocket is designed to take humans back to the moon. Artemis, NASA's future lunar expedition, is about to get a little closer to an official release date. The STAT spacecraft and rocket have been approved to roll out from Kennedy Space Center's launch pad in Cape Canaveral, Florida. If the weather permits, this mega rocket will make the 4-mile journey from the assembly building to the launch pad, where further tests will be conducted. The estimated time for this journey is expected to be 11 hours. Engineers will spend roughly 2 weeks preparing for a wet dress rehearsal after the spacecraft and rocket have been positioned at the launch pad. These tests confirm that the rocket can be loaded with super-cold liquid propellants. The wet dress rehearsals, call to stations, is planned to take place on April the 1st, with tanking operations beginning on April the 3rd. The live coverage for the Artemis 1 rollout will begin on the 17th of March. Before wrapping up the rehearsal, draining the fuel tanks, and preparing the rocket for its return to the vehicle assembly building, which should take another 8 to 9 days, engineers and technicians will practice the launch countdown to just inside T-10 seconds to test the rocket's responses to a flight termination scenario. The Orion spacecraft can hold up to 4 people, but when the Artemis 1 mission launches later this year, it will be devoid of humans. Orion will transport men into orbit, sustain them throughout their moon trips, and keep them safe during re-entry from deep space in future Artemis missions. With Artemis missions, NASA will achieve this accomplishment of landing the first woman and first person of color on the moon, using innovative technologies to explore more of a lunar surface than ever before. NASA will set an official launch date for Artemis 1 after the rollout, assuming all tests are successful. Artemis 1 is an unmanned spacecraft that will go thousands of kilometers beyond the moon before returning to Earth in 3 weeks. Artemis 2 will take a crew on a lunar flyby, and Artemis 3, the mission's ultimate stage, will bring people to the lunar surface for the first time since the Apollo 17 moonwalks in 1972. This is just the start. The end goal has always been the colonization of Mars. This will be a giant leap in terms of space advancement. What do you guys have to say?